Welcome to the weather briefing for the week of May 23rd, 2013. This briefing brought to you by the National Weather Service in Riverton. As we take a look at the snowpack water content that's still out there, the pinks and oranges indicating where areas where we're generally below about 70% across the state right now. Still a few places hanging on in the 80s. But overall, we've melted most of the snowpack below about 9,500 feet, so we'll get a secondary surge of water as we really start to get into the summertime from that high elevation snow, but for the most part, we've melted off the bulk of the lower elevation snow. So let's take a look at the upcoming week. We'll start here with Friday, and the map that we're looking at here where we see this lighter shading denoted by the pinks and the purples and even some greens, that's where we have possibility of precipitation generated by our forecast models. And then we can see the background image with these oranges and yellows and reds. That's where we have some of the warmer air starting to work in. So low pressure sitting up over the Pacific Northwest, counterclockwise rotation running parallel to these lines of pressure here, and so we're going to see a southwesterly flow, drier air pumping into the state. Looks like a generally dry day on Friday, temperatures climbing to just above normal temperature readings. For Saturday, that southwest flow continues for the most part, keeping things very warm and breezy and dry across especially the southwest and central portions of the state. We might see some thunderstorms and showers kick off over the northwestern mountains, but overall warmer and breezy. The best wind will be from Rock Springs to Casper in what we call the wind corridor, where speeds will be generally 15 to 30 miles an hour out of the southwest. For Sunday, still generally much of the same across southwest Wyoming. That dry air continues to work in on southwesterly flow aloft. We'll see some return low-level moisture out of the southeast that sets the stage for some showers and thunderstorms generally across the northern Bighorn Basin, Johnson County. Those areas will be best chances for seeing that Sunday, but overall things will remain warm and breezy and generally dry still on Sunday. Now as we head to Memorial Day, that low pressure system kind of starts to move backwards as another piece of energy from that low starts to dive south along the western coast. A little bit more moisture working its way eastward into the state. Some energy also nudging to the east, so that's going to set the stage for some strong thunderstorms across generally the northern half and possibly the western portions of the state. Memorial Day afternoon and early evening, a little bit cooler that day, not much, still running about 5 to 10 degrees above normal, but Memorial Day afternoon still bears some watching to see what happens with those thunderstorms across the north. For Tuesday and Wednesday, it'll be slightly cooler as that low pressure system begins to move onshore and into the desert southwest, and as it does so, it looks like moisture is going to pump in up ahead of that and start to move moisture across the state. Also, another little weak disturbance looks to move across the region, so that's going to set the stage for increasing chance of precipitation, some showers and thunderstorms. A little bit cooler, less sun to get into the area, and we'll cool things down a little bit. Let's take a look at the temperatures at a glance. Here's high temperatures. You can kind of see the trends warming up from Friday into the weekend, kind of maintaining the status quo, a little bit cooler as we head towards the middle part of next week. As for low temperatures, other than Jackson starting off a little bit cool to end this week, overall temperatures above freezing, so looks like those of you who have put plants or flowers in the ground, looks like things will be good for you for at least the next week. Taking a look ahead for the state, we saw that trough low pressure that's kind of hanging around the west coast. Well, it looks like that pattern may persist and keep us, or at least areas to our west, in below normal temperature pattern where a ridge of high pressure builds up over the eastern United States. So that's where we see that above normal temperatures kind of bullseyed across that area. Moisture looks like kind of an active flow maybe across the north as well. We'll have to see how that pans out. Looks maybe more like the bigger issue could be temperatures as we get into early June. So we want to wish everyone a safe and happy Memorial Day weekend, and by that we mean that you'll spend time with your loved ones and remember those who have fought and for our country and risked their lives or even spent their lives. We're very thankful for them. If you have any needs for information this weekend, please call us 1-800-211-1448 or check us out mobile.weather.gov on your smartphone. Thank you for joining us.